Hi everyone, I am very happy to make this video today. It's the introducing of the new civilization, the Crescent one. This is my first step on it, so let's go together take a look inside. So let's see the inside of the castle, the design in the first place, to see how it looks, the Arabian civilization. I like the details because the golden, the blue spots of the oasis on the desert, the sand, the rocks. This is a very fantasy world of Arabian, so I like it very much. I feel like in Aladdin or other things, it is really enjoyable. I like it. This is just messy right now because I don't know where is the buildings. When I will find out, it will be very nice. For example, I will look for the farm, well, in front of the castle, that's the chain, and there is on the sand on the beach, so will be easy to find them. Right now what I am interested by is the design of the castle outside. Well, I feel a little disappointed about it because we know already this castle. This castle is the Falcon Golden Castle, or at least it is the Falcon Castle, because there is a slight difference that we will be noticed between the two. I am disappointed because it's not new. I was expecting a new design for the castle. So as we already have it for most of us, and it's just a disappointment for me. Let's go to see the difference between the civilization skin and the golden one. I will just go switch inside on the merchant so I see where is my merchant, so it's a big step. Here it is, the golden falcon. Well, here is the difference. You have like a glowing golden glowing on the castle. This is the only difference between the two. Well, let's go back inside and see what next. While I am looking for the prayer hall or the discipline hall to take a look to the T13, the elephant war, what is different from the other civilizations? It's before for unlock troops for the new civilization, it was T12. Here now it's T13, so it's a big difference between the civilization, because it will be unlocked in the siege tower, not in the civilization science. So let's go. I am trying to see in which book we have to unlock it. There is nothing different from the previous civilization. To unlock the T13 war elephant, you will have a book, War Elephant, and then you do the few research before enlist, then you got them. I will not do it today because tomorrow is the science phase from Kingdom Conquest, so I will wait tomorrow to unlock them. You will have also in discipline book few research to train faster and heal faster. I have made some, but I will wait tomorrow to go further. What is interesting also is that we already have a glimpse of the war elephant in a fight. I will give you an avant-première about it. You will see right now a little report part where you can see elephant war in a battlefield. Here we can see the four talents that we will have to enhance for them. Tusk Spurt, Golden Armor, Invincible Might, a War Trample. War Elephant is a siege engine kind of troop. So for those who are late behind, we will have to catch up our science on it. Of course, do the research on the Sage Tower and enhance them, so for be able to be competitive with them. I don't know for yet what would be the impact on defense, but for sure this troop are defensive ones, so we'll use them in battle to
absorb the damage for the other troops, and also in background in our castles. But it's tier 13, so it would be costly, so we'll not have a lot of them, I guess, in my castle.
Well, it's suddenly very sunny inside the castle with the new civilization. Well, for now we will go see the civilization itself with the sciences. So go check the civilization temple. Well, we will begin by the popularity so we can see the details of the civilization. I really like the outfit, the decorum of the civilization, and it matched with my pick, so I am very happy about it. So always, for increase your popularity, you will have monster skills and donations. So with the military ranking who will be reset, well, I think we will kill a lot in the next days. So if we want to see the detail of the popularity, so here we come. It's essentially health, with increased health, defensive damages, bonus of all units defense, so and so on. So the civilization is really based on the defense. That is his characteristic. So for people who want increase the defense, it will be the chosen one. You can have also support skills with increase the reward of the killing monsters. You will also unlock the fire eagle, so we will take a look a little later on it. What is new when you go in friendly? Yes, you will have Mansour. To unlock Mansour is the hero I will show you in a few. So basically, here are the four science. I will scroll down. Okay. So fight alone, it will increase your defensive HP when you attack in solo. The max is 6%. Wiping out is your defensive damage reduction not taken. Maximum when you will reach worship, it's 5%. Endless fortune, it will be a chance to increase the reward of the killing monster. That is just very good for getting 1 hour shields and so on. On it, we can combine it with Eagle Hero or the new hero. I didn't watch specifically the details for now. And of course, a defense bonus, 70%. The defense bonus is very interesting and very important. So if I see in respect, okay, respect, you already reach with respect 30%, so is not neglectable. It's very interesting for raising our defense. For the civilization, we will go now see the details of the science itself. Always in ancestral spirit, you scroll. Why I don't want to scroll. Oops, here it is, Soul of the Crescent. Rage of Desert is a tree similar to the other civilization. The difference is that in this time it's focused on Yuashire. Sorry for my pronunciation, for Yuashire counter civilization. So as we all stay a long time in the Chinese civilization, we are very developed on it, so it will be interested to develop here to see the opposition. But of course, what is interesting is that is the identity of the civilization, the defense. So here you will not find offensive damages, but you will find defensive. I remind that all the civilization works same time, even if you don't wear the proper civilization. So it is really important to do them for all the civilization. I know most of us know this, but sometimes it's just fine to remind, because there is also new people who play, or just people who don't know. So if I see defensive damage, yes. So definitely we will have to research there. Crescent Legion. So no troops to unlock, but research to do. Same as the other civilization, you will have the defense part and offensive and DD parts. Well, but it's I just noticed it's blocked to level 5, so it's 2% and half. Let's just take a look here. Yes, it is not developed till level 7 like the other civilization, but we take what we can where we can. With the civilization, we have two heroes who had been released today. One is for the civilization itself, and the other is a support one. It is like Julia or Bartholdi or Sonia. It will help you to decrease the needs of the crystal for your research, so you will be able to catch up and research faster. You have a very interesting tree with the civilization for decrease the reduction of civilization crystal needed. And that you have it by civilization, so you will be able to catch up on the former one, like Dragonborn, Yamato, you have Viking, and also you have Washiai. So those skills is today very needed for catch up on our research, because there is a lot of max castle. I like the design of the hero. It's an elf who is dressed like Elsa from Frozen, so I think it's very beautiful, so very design interesting. Also, we have to meet today Mansour. Mansour is the hero of the civilization itself. It's one who will help you to develop and accelerate the rising of the different level of the civilization. You can get more percentage by donating. You can also raise your income. And finally, with the support one, I like it, is the ability to increase the popularity for your daily activity, like killing monster, killing troops, or doing your dragon boss. This is very interesting. The part of the income is interesting for get always in your pawn store sufficient to buy shards. You have actually on sales the shard of the Eagle Fire and the new hero. So if we go in our cave, you will find your eagle. The eagle is a dragon, who is not a dragon, who will help you to develop your defensive damage and your defensive damage taken. I find the first skill very not useful. I think we can switch on other thing as soon as we get it. The second one, well, can be helpful in the first time for help us to get more items in of popularity for raising the different level faster, but when we have enough, we can switch it. I like the skills of the Fire Eagle. The must have will of Broiling Sun. It will be the ability to increase the Supreme Legion's damage. So more damages on the T-13 is exactly what we needed, because there was not over steroid right now. But I think it will be a must-have. You have one, I don't understand to get it in a defensive eagle. It's the ability to turn a dead soldier into wounded, as I probably will use it for defense or else. I cannot see the use of get wounded instead dying soldier, as it all will depend from the hospital capacity. Well, this is the end of our tour. I hope you enjoyed the visit, and thank you for watching. Subscribe if you want to have the latest news of PSR 4016 and get the coverage of different events I can do, as for now I am doing the Dreamy Engine coverage. So subscribe and comment below about what you think about the new civilization, and have fun of discover it and develop it, and see you soon. Enjoy and have a nice play.